Hollenbeck units in 4071, 4071 at 211 just occurred, New Jersey and Savannah, New Jersey and Savannah. Suspects are armed with a handgun. They're described as three male Caucasians, all wearing white shirts, one wearing a cap. They were last seen walking southbound on Savannah. 4071,
MX-118, do you have a message for Savannah? Subject, change your location, we're returning.
All right, people, let's get into it. Today we are on episode 3 of How to Light. Episode 1 and 2 can be found up here, and some of the stuff we're going to be going over kind of piggybacks on some of the concepts we've talked about in those. So if you haven't seen those, check those out, come back, because we're building on the things that we are learning and talking about. Now today, we are talking about how to light a car interior. This scene obviously is set at night and outside. We're inside the car, but the car is outside, right? Due to scheduling, we had to actually shoot this during the day. And as such, we actually pulled the car into a garage, blacked out all of the windows, and filmed this inside. We covered all of the windows and garage door with contractor trash bags. These are big, heavy-duty black trash bags that are thick enough that it will block out all of the available light. So we taped those to the windows from outside the garage to block off any spill, making it completely dark inside the garage. Of course, being inside a garage, that is a small, confined space, and cars, as you all know, are completely covered with windows. So before we could even light our space to make it look like we were filming at night, we needed to obscure the windows in a way that we then wouldn't see the outside world. A great way to obscure windows, and something you often see in movies, is of course to add elements outside, things like rain. In this case, we're in a garage, so we're not going to be pumping water into the garage, but we knew we could sell a lot of that effect in post with sound.
Hollenbeck units in 4071, 4071 at 211 just occurred, New Jersey and Savannah, New Jersey and Savannah.
To cover our windows, or to obscure our windows in a way that we that wouldn't see the garage door and the light stands and all the people and things that are standing around in pretty close proximity, we did two things. The first thing is this. This is called dulling spray. And the nice thing about dulling spray is that it is removable and pretty easily removable. But this acts as a frosting agent. So when you think about like frosted glass, you can still see kind of light through them, but you don't get to actually see through the window itself. And dulling spray does a great job of emulating that kind of effect. And because it's in an aerosol can like this, it's not necessarily going to give you very even spread. It's going to have a lot of kind of personality and imperfections in it, which is kind of what I wanted. But it's raining, it's not snowing. So what we then did after that is we took a mixture of glycerin and water. Glycerin is a very viscous or very thick, clear liquid. Also happens to be kind of sticky. I wanted the water to stick to the window and not completely just roll off and beat off the way that it would with water, but the glycerin on its own is a little bit too viscous, so the mixture of the two gave me something that would run a little bit, but not a lot, to make it feel as though there was rain or water droplets coming down the window, again, without having to use actual water or a hose and all of that to get that effect. Night sequences in film are lit in a way that feel like night, not that necessarily look like night. And that's the entire purpose of lighting. It's to help tell our story. So for this setup, I wanted this to feel like the car was parked at night somewhere in an industrial kind of city area that would probably have a sodium vapor light. If you're not familiar, those street lamps that you would find in like parking lots or on the side of the street where that has that really orange light, that's a sodium vapor light. And I wanted that light to be our main source of illumination for this scene. To do that, we then took two 2x1 Gemini lights, which are already massive fixtures, put those two lights in a dual array up on a combo stand and touched the ceiling of the garage with it, pointed it down at the corner or the A pillar of our car. Now, when we have our brightest light, our key light, behind the talent in comparison to the camera, so camera, talent, light, that is what we would call reverse key lighting or upstage lighting. It's a really, really cool mechanic that adds a lot of drama to our shots. It's not always appropriate, but depending on the story that we're telling, it does make a very, very cool look. And because we want this to feel very gritty and very stylized, much like a John Wick kind of look to it, we didn't want to then just blast the same kind of orange light or slightly whiter light back onto our subject. We wanted to give it a stylized look. Something we went over in the bar sequence is the idea of contrasting and complementary colors. Look at a color wheel, go from one side of the wheel to the other side of the wheel. Those two colors, while being opposite, those contrasting colors, will complement. The opposite of orange is this greenish teal color, and we didn't want so much of it that it looks like a new light source. We wanted just enough of it that the light would illuminate our subject's face, while at the same time getting that cool complementary contrasting light color. So we took 2 1x1 Gemini lights. We put one outside of the window on the front of the car, and we then took the other, opened the tailgate of the car itself, put that inside of a softbox to kind of shape that light down, and shone it through the back of the car. This gave us a fill light that kind of acted as a wrap because it's coming from kind of two different directions onto our talent. So we can have this really, really nice hard key, but have this really nice soft fill wrap that's coming back up. We didn't need a whole lot of power on those two lights. I mean, I truthfully think that they were set like somewhere between like 5% and 10%, but it's just enough of a pop that it gives us a lot of depth and detail in our subjects. Again, lighting bright for the spaces that we're in. If we didn't put those lights there, we could have this cool kind of silhouette-y look. But the problem with that is if we don't have definition on our characters, if we don't have catch lights in the eyes, if we don't see the skin tones of the people that we're filming, and it all just falls into kind of muddy darkness, we lose our storytelling capacity to really showcase an entire image. That's the key light. Those are our fill lights. And again, the idea of lighting spaces and not faces, by having those three lights set up outside of the car, pointed in the car, gave us the ability to have the camera operator kind of move in and around the space without having to change and set up lights for each of our shots. Now, we also had an effect light, which is the police lights, right? You see, as we hear the sirens come up, we see the lights kind of flash across the face. And that effect was pretty simple. We took a 1x1 Gemini light, we put a 40-degree grid on that, or a honeycomb on that, and just had somebody Hollywood that light. So those lights can be powered by battery, which makes them really easy to move around. And so we just had somebody take the light, and Hollywooding, again, is what holding is. So when you hear somebody, can you Hollywood this or Hollywood that, it just means, can you hold that and become the stand yourself? So we had somebody Hollywooding that light, and they would just do a pass over the subject as if there were police cars that were driving by. And this goes to show, by the way, that your setups don't have to be super complicated, and you can sell a lot of the effects, both in terms of lighting and kind of the overall aesthetic, with your sound design. Audio is that important that you can make those feel the way that you want without having to go super extra or extreme with the way that they look. If there's a particular scene that you would like to know how it should be lit, go ahead and comment that down below. This series is going to continue until we run out of things to light, which I don't think we ever will, but there you go. If you liked this video and you found it helpful, do me two favors. The first, give the video a like, and secondly, subscribe if you haven't already, and click that little bell icon so you know when the next videos come out. And as always, I will see you in the next episode.
All back units in 4071, 4071 at 211 just occurred, New Jersey and Savannah, New Jersey and Savannah. Suspects are armed with a handgun. They're described as 3 male Caucasians, all wearing white shirts, blue jeans, one wearing a cap. They were last seen walking southbound on Savannah. 4071.
MX-118, do you have a Mr. Kerr in Savannah? Subject change of location.